So we're on event number one of the preseason online tour, the ZOZO Championship at Pelican Hill Golf Club. See if we can hit a fairway on hole number one. Elevation is almost 100 feet downhill, so if we hit this one good, we'll get some good distance out of it. A little slicey. Well, we got a favorable lucky bounce for that slicey shot. So straight from the dinner table to swinging golf clubs and little fat little... Oh, a lot of sink there. 148, 32 feet downhill. I'm going to hit my pitching wedge. Start. Short par 4 with 344 yards. On a good day, I would only be hitting a 3 or 4 iron off the tee for a hole like this at this distance, but haven't been hitting those clubs very well either. Basically an 11 footer. It's only 2 inches downhill. Not sure how that one could have went that far past that hole for 2 inches downhill. So we got 17 feet, 9 inches uphill now. That was a mistake. Well, so much for birdieing the first hole and bogey the second hole, and it's a great start. Jeez. Isn't that golf, though? Enough to make you want to scream. It's another really short hole here. Probably hit a 4-iron here. I don't need much over 220. Yeah. 110 left. Do this, a nice little sand wedge for me. Get one on the line. It's right of the flag, gotta go. Live without these 30 footers, in this case 1 foot uphill, so about 43 feet. Well, we had it if we would have hit it. Hole 4, 123, but playing 37 feet downhill. It's not going to take much, 110 shot sand wedge. I didn't hit it. Shoot. Go. Kind of deserved that. This is about a 50 footer with that 11 inches uphill. What was that? I might have been on the edge of the fringe or something. I forgot about that. That was one of those sticky putts. That's a save for par. Feet downhill and see. It's only 280, really. Be an okay line for a touch and a fade if we can get a nice shot. Go, ball. Go, ball! I thought that was going to be hard enough. never played this course before, and it's quite nice. A lot of elevation. To be honest with you, I'm not even familiar where it is. We got 110 left, 17 feet uphill. Try to get a sand wedge in there somewhat close. Well, I pushed it right and I didn't hit it very good. Stay on the green. So compared to the real world environment for my location, my carry distances are so much different than E6 Connect that I find it hard to pick the right club. Everything in E6 Connect goes a lot further. So some of my clubs and my carry distances I'm very familiar with in the real world. I struggle with a little bit playing sim golf. Not so much on FSX 2020, but definitely on E6 Connect. I have that trouble. And then I have the trouble of just being an amateur and an average golfer. That's always the other factor. So this one with 16 inches uphill, 67 foot, really turns it into about 83 feet. So if we get this close, we're pretty impressed. Stop. 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 So we have to go up that hill, but as soon as it reached the peak of that hill, obviously what goes up must come down, and a little too much pace on that one. Leaves us with a 10 footer for par. Another lucky save there. So off the cuff, this thing is playing 167, 24 feet downhill. Calculated to about 159. Now I would typically hit my 9-iron about 155. On this game, we're going to see. See where we're aimed at, because we don't want to right at that flag. Is that the right club? Good shot. Those are the putts you can't miss. Simulated golf or real golf, you can't miss those. 8 foot for bird. I've got a few choice words for that. It's a decent length par 5. Off the tee, it was uphill a lot. Kind of needed the downhill for par 5. But it looks like we can get something about 250, low and rolling with a touch of draw on it, we might be able to get to that back flag location, but this is going to have to be hit perfect. Did we hit it perfect? Go! Well, that was about everything I got with a 3-iron. I consider that a good strike. Eagle chance, 42 feet, 7 inches uphill. About 49-foot putt here, all uphill. Watch that one again on the video. That couldn't have been a better putt. I think a quarter roll less that wasn't going in, but that was a great eagle. Hell, I'm even impressed. That's pretty good. Great eagle. Needed that one. Kind of hitting them off the heel here today. I think that left us with a lot. 173. Kind of going for about a 167 carry. Hit my 8-iron. It's about the right number in my real world environment for my 8-iron, so. See if we can get this thing. What's left? It's gonna go far down. Come on, get on the green. So we yanked that one. Not my best shot, that one. Nasty pull. See, last time I was right on the fringe like that with the putter, showing me the putting line, it wasn't enough. No matter how hard I hit it, it wasn't enough, so I don't think I want to learn again and leave myself with a big second putt. Just going to see if we can use a gap wedge and roll one in there. Carried it a bit too far, so I didn't use any of the break at all, but inside the gimme range, we'll take it. We'll take that par. That second, that approach shot wasn't very pretty. Hole 10. Healy as well. So 170, 12 foot downhill, probably playing about 166. Try this 8-iron again and try not to pull it. So I have a habit with usually my 8, my 9, and from time to time my pitching wedge. I'm pretty good at kind of pulling them left when I try to get a little bit more out of them. I'm working on that, but it's easy to fall back into your old ways as well. And I've had 3 or 4 of those already today. So this one's playing about 15 feet downhill. I'm going to try to only tap it about 12. No, in fact, I needed it about all 15 of it. That one was hit on the button. I think that's the first center strike I had with my driver in the last 10 holes or however many times I've used it. Nice little 44 yards left. Kind of an awkward distance. Again, like I said on a few holes ago, for something a par 4 that short, I typically wouldn't hit my driver. I'd hit a 3-iron or something, leave a realistic number in. But, because that happens. Why did I mess that up? Yeah, that can happen right there. So we got 55 feet. Yeah, that was just a complete, I should shut my mouth and play golf, not thinking about that. Well, we just barely got it there, and we needed that one to be in the gimme range. That was a forced error, flapping my lips instead of my arms. Par 3, 191, playing 4 feet downhill. I think this 6-iron is going to be too much. Sometimes an E6 connect, a 7-iron can be too much. So I'm gonna choose a 7-iron. I'm hoping it's gonna be in a great spot. I'm gonna try to hit a touch of draw and not hook it. On E6 connect, my 7-iron can go about 200 yards, but in real world, it's about 177, 180, so. Oh, I like that kind. Seven footer left. Finally capitalized on a good tee shot there. This is back-to-back par 3s. You don't see that every day. 99 yards, 22 feet downhill. This is only a 90-yard, maybe a 90-yard carry. This is pretty much a guess. my lob wedge is about 95 yards, real world environment. So we'll see how this one goes. Oh, I think I pulled the hell out of that. I don't know where that was aiming. I hit it dead straight. I think the aim was way over to the left side of the green. I didn't look where it was aiming. That was my mistake. I hit that ball straight and it went way left. So obviously there's an aiming issue on the green there, and I didn't look to see where the flag or where the aiming point was. And that is gonna be a costly mistake. If we're gonna miss anywhere, we want to miss it right. And if you guys watch my drives, that's typically where my miss is. The driver. Yep. That was a slice off the toe. Get over the trees. Ah, that made it hard. We got. You know, this was an easy reachable par 5 if you would have got a tee shot. You know, whale on a hybrid and slice something down that direction. Cut. Come on. Shoot. All right, we're not making it any easy on ourselves, but we're down here. A 50-yard shot. Track, but I think that was a par and an easy reachable par 5. I screwed that one up all the way down there, all the way down the fairway. Looks like 131, 29, well, 30 feet uphill, playing 140 yards. Get this pitching wedge somewhere in there. It's a little right. Alright, I'll live with that. Thank you. 17-foot putt here for birdie. Oh, stop. Wow, I blew that right by the hole. Heck. What is going on? Those were two simple putts. What the heck? Wow. Oh man, that was terrible. I would like to do that all over again. What the heck was that? Just a bogey or a double? Looks like a bogey. Ouch. I need to land this somewhere like 194. I'll take 194 six iron right now. Get down. Get down. Inch outside the gimme zone. 5 foot left. See if we can get something on this par 5 happening. I three putted that two holes ago and I'm still feeling the sting on that one. Oh, get right. There we go, hit the path. I expected a little more hop off that path. So we didn't get a far enough drive to go at the pin in two. I don't carry a three wood. I only carry a three hybrid, and I can't get 290 out of a three hybrid, so we're not even going to attempt that. A little fat, but we'll be all right. Having a hell of a time judging those 80 to 100 yard shots. A heck of a time judging those. Go. missed opportunity. True 284. I hit a driver to the end of that little first fairway there. Oh, that's a slicey one. Looks like 194. 194 and a cut shot. I don't know if 6-iron's the right club for a fade, but I'm gonna give it a shot. Didn't cut. It's pretty straight. Got it a little thin and just never got the fade. Now, 34 yards. Roll, baby, roll. Feels like the last few holes have been just pure defense here. That's exactly what it's been, it's defense. I barely tapped that ball. Didn't realize that was hole 18 either.